Hello, familia. Glory be to God for another beautiful day. We are on Exodus chapter 14. Hallelujah. Let us all hear the word together today. In the mighty name of Jesus, I pray and I give thanks to Yahweh, Holy One of Israel, that I believe he has heard our prayer this day. Hallelujah and amen. Then the Lord spoke to Moshe, tell the Israelites to turn back and camp in front of Pi Hahiroth, between Migdol and the sea. You must camp in front of Baal Zephon, facing it by the sea. Pharaoh will say of the Israelites, they are wandering around the land in confusion. The wilderness has boxed them in. I will harden Pharaoh's heart so that he will pursue them. Then I will receive glory by means of Pharaoh and all his army, and the Egyptians will know that I am Yahweh. So the Israelites did this. When the king of Egypt was told that the people had fled, Pharaoh and his officials changed their minds about the people and said, what have we done? We have released Israel from serving us. So he got his chariot ready and took his troops with him. He took 600 of the best chariots and all the rest of the chariots of Egypt with officers in each one. The Lord hardened the heart of Pharaoh, king of Egypt, and he pursued the Israelites who were going out triumphantly. The Egyptians, all Pharaoh's horses and chariots, his horsemen and his army, chased after them and caught up with them as they camped by the sea beside Pi Hahiroth in front of Baal Zephon. As Pharaoh approached, the Israelites looked up and saw the Egyptians coming after them. Then the Israelites were terrified and cried out to the Lord for help. They said to Moshe, is it because there are no graves in Egypt that you took us to die in the wilderness? What have you done to us by bringing us out of Egypt? Isn't this what we told you in Egypt? Leave us alone so that we may serve the Egyptians. It would have been better for us to serve the Egyptians than to die in the wilderness. But Moshe said to the people, don't be afraid. Stand firm and see the Lord's salvation. He will provide for you today. For the Egyptians you see today, you will never see again. The Lord will fight for you. You must be quiet. Glory be to God, I believe. Hallelujah. The Lord said to Moshe, why are you crying out to me? Tell the Israelites to break camp. As for you, lift up your staff, stretch out your hand over the sea and divide it, so that the Israelites can go through the sea on dry ground. I am going to harden the hearts of the Egyptians, so that they will go in after them, and I will receive glory by means of Pharaoh, all his army, and his chariots and horsemen. The Egyptians will know that I am Yahweh when I receive glory through Pharaoh, his chariots, and his horsemen. Then the angel of God, who was going in front of the Israelite forces, moved and went behind them. The pillar of cloud moved from in front of them and stood behind them. It came between the Egyptian and Israelite forces. The cloud was there in darkness, yet it lit up the night. So neither group came near the other all night long. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Then Moshe stretched out his hand over the sea. The Lord drove the sea back with a powerful east wind all that night and turned the sea into dry land. So the waters were divided, and the Israelites went through the sea on dry ground, with the waters like a wall to them on their right and their left. Glory, hallelujah! I believe he is still doing this today. Glory, hallelujah, he is. The Egyptians set out in pursuit, all Pharaoh's horses, his chariots, and his horsemen, and went into the sea after them. Then, during the morning watch, the Lord looked down on the Egyptian forces from the pillar of fire and cloud, and threw them into confusion. He caused their chariot wheels to swerve and made them drive with difficulty. Glory be to God, our God is good. Let's get away from Israel, the Egyptians said, because Yahweh is fighting for them against Egypt. Hallelujah, he is. Then the Lord said to Moshe, stretch out your hand over the sea so that the waters may come back on the Egyptians, on their chariots and horsemen. So Moshe stretched out his hand over the sea, and at daybreak the sea returned to its normal depth. While the Egyptians were trying to escape from it, The Lord threw them into the sea. The waters came back and covered the chariots and horsemen, the entire army of Pharaoh that had gone after them into the sea. Glory be to God, none of them survived. But the Israelites had walked through the sea on dry ground, with the waters like a wall, to them on their right and their left. That day the Lord saved Israel from the power of the Egyptians. And Israel saw the Egyptians dead on the seashore. When Israel saw the great power that the Lord used against the Egyptians, the people feared the Lord and believed in him and in his servant Moses. Glory be to God. May we all believe the word of the Lord. May we believe what he is telling us. In the mighty name of Jesus, he is leading us out. No matter what our situations may look like, he's leading us out of Egypt. And he is leading us away from our own Egypt in our hearts, the own deceit that we tell ourselves. Glory be to God, he is. May we be more empowered to believe this every single day in the mighty name of Jesus. And this includes me as well. Because I too grow weary, familia. I too groan and just wonder how long, Abba Father, are we going to be in this wilderness? And they weren't even in there that long. And they were already, complaining. But that's us. That's us too. And so may we all be empowered more to just trust him in the mighty name of Jesus, I pray. Hallelujah and amen. Let it be so, Abba Father. They're just words unless you do the thing. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah and amen. Bye, familia.